years. We've been trying to get the owner of the site to speak to us since 2009. Our company that we set up in 2011 is called Athabasca Regeneration Company, King UC Limited, and we thought we'll never remember that or say it correctly. So we've come down to the ark that survived lots of storms. So we're ARC, King UC. And we are also very proud that we got our charitable status last year. So our number goes on everything. The first thing is, where exactly is King UC? Or as you hear it on Radio 4 or sometimes in Radio Scotland as King Gussie. We're not. There we are. Our sign means at the head of the Pinewood, and we're the capital of Beinnoch, and that's our gateway sign. Now we're opposite, if you're going up the A9, we're opposite the building that you see that's all illuminated at night, and that's Ruthven Barracks. And commonly known in the town as the castle, because there's been a fortified settlement there since, well, before Adam was a boy. Best way to describe it, but we are the town opposite, and we're a town, and we're proud to be a town because we had a provost, and that's what. And if anybody in the town refers to us as a village, they get told. So that's it. Where are we? We're 12 miles south of Aviemore, who get 1 million visitors a year. We're 5 miles west of the Highland Wildlife Park, who get 160,000 visitors a year. We are 3 miles from the Highland Folk Museum. They get 60,000 visitors a year. And we were also used to film Monarch of the Glen. We used to have part of the Highland Folk Museum, and the council closed it in 2008, and it has been used as a store to 2013. The various academic studies that were done, when the museum was open, we had one study that was sponsored by the council, said we got 20,000 visitors a year. An independent study said we got 38,000 visitors a year. So when we all closed down, we lost those. And when Monarch stopped being broadcast all over the world, we lost the busloads of visitors that came to our town. So, 2008, the museum closed to visitors, and the high street started to die. And people said, it's like the Mary Celeste down there, and people said, there's nobody about. And you know, I got parked today was another expression that was used. Before, people couldn't get parked because of visitors' cars. It started to show. Shops started to close. B&Bs started to go up for sale. B&Bs started saying, we're not full again. It had an economic impact in our town. And then people started saying, what are we going to do about this? What can we do about it? We've lost our museum, was the other thing. And then the cry went out, we'll have to do something. In King UC, we're between two sets of mountains. We've got the foothills of the Grampians on one side of us, and we've got the Mauna Lea on the other. And in between, you get your feet wet because you've got the River Stour. So a piece of flat, accessible ground is a big bonus to us. A piece of land that doesn't flood. Now, what have we got? We have the Highland Folk Museum. Let's talk to the landowners. Ah, but the landowners were speaking to somebody else. And I saw them with my own eyes. I saw two of the local developers hanging over the gate, having a look. So it was about time the community started to do something. What did we start doing to try and get the project underway? We did the town trail. Can you see Time Trail? Can be walked in 3-inch heels, because I've done it, is DDA compliant. We started the Heritage Festival, a little plug, the last weekend in April next year, 3-day programme, guarantee you're a good welcome if you come along, and it's now in its 5th year. And all our stories project, and I was delighted to see the cake next door, because we celebrate everything with cake in Can You See? And that was our cake with all our Heritage in Heritage Lottery Fund sponsored us with Leader, and we did that. We've got 12 boards, and the logo was designed by the local school. It's the Ruthven Barracks and the town clock. Then we decided we had to see if we could get ideas of what people wanted, but we realised this site could be sold from underneath us. So we went for community right to buy registrations, and part of that is a consultation, and that was our big question. Our oldest consultee was 107. She wanted a seat with a garden that she could sit in and a nice day. And our youngest consultee was a 4-year-old, where he wanted ice cream and somewhere to play when his mum could sit. So he's now 11? Nine. What's on the site? Pitmain Lodge. Built in 1790, it's rubble, it's rotten, we suspect that we'll take it back to the walls. The floors are held up by stanchions, there's water running through the roof, every window leaks, but it's our building. That's it. It's on a site of 3 acres. The former telephone exchange, anything but pretty. And McRobert House, which is pretty, built in the early 1800s. Nice building, best state of repair of all the buildings on the site. And then we've got that. And that is important, because that leads up to the graveyard that surrounds our parish church. And that is known as the Mound of the Court. And that is where the Wolf of Badenoch held his court when his fort was on the site of Ruthven Barracks. That is very, very important for us. At present, what we've got? We've got these buildings, we've got a big agricultural shed at the back, and we've already acquired a part of the site, and we've built allotments and growing spaces for community use. And our community heritage orchard is in that area there at the present time, the one that looks like the old railway line zone, little whatever's that look there. Now, the plan for the future, very exciting. We've got the ideas that we're putting forward that all came from the community is that we have our learning centre goes into McRobert House, Pitmain Lodge is, and the whole site is regenerated, and it's arts and crafts, a training restaurant to go in, and what else have we got? And craft workshops. Because across the road, what we've also got is we've got the only community-operated art gallery in the Central Highlands, in the Iona Gallery, and there is a demand for arts and crafts. To this, there's two overreaching themes, and the theme, big theme, important thing for us is heritage, because we've got it by the bucket load. And the biggest growth area in tourism is heritage and genealogy. And the other is arts and crafts, because Scotland has got so much to offer. Now, somebody said to me, How do you, and Mary, explain to me, how do you get heritage into your training restaurant? Easy peasy. Beautiful wall displays. Beautiful colouring in sheets for your under fives. And your play area to keep the kids happy is heritage themed. And boy, do we have a winner. We've got the Wolf of Badenoch. And he, you know, young kids, they love blood and gore. That's what we're going to bring them in with. We're going to have the best play area that you've ever come across, and a heritage themed one. However, one thing, what we've got to do, we've made the commitment, we're a social enterprise. Any profits will go back into our community. We've got to look at it from the economic point of view. We've got to be commercially aware. We've got to have a social benefit to make our community proud. And we've got to make it environmentally friendly, because we don't want to. We're 45 miles from Inverness. We want people to come to us. We want a decent bus service. We're on a train line. Come down. And that's what we're planning to do. Who have I got to thank for all the help and assistance that we've had? Our local third sector organisation, Voluntary Action Badenoch and Strathspey, Community Ownership Support Service, and HI have all worked their socks off for us. We've got three advisors, they're angels. I keep telling them that, and I keep on saying star and angel points in all their emails. We have gone to the professionals, we've got all the documentation. Who are the landowners? The landowners started to talk to us in last year in February. They actually took us seriously when we handed a portfolio into them that was 5 inches high with all the work that we had done. We're going to get there, because this week, after having had people having to kick a little butt, we've been promised a letter of comfort from the council saying that they will hand it over to us for £1. We'll have to argue who's going to pay the legal fees and expenses, but I would like to thank all the agencies that we've used, because I'm sure working with us has been their worst nightmare. We've always been nice, but we've always been saying, but what if? You know, but what if? And they've always been very patient, and I would like to thank them for that. So, can I invite, when we're up and running, can you all come and see us, please? And you'll be made the most welcome. You asked what help we needed. We need all the help you can give us, because we need to get our heritage right. And it's from the wee 4-year-old to the wee 3-year-old to the 107-year-old. That we've got to satisfy on that side. So thank you very much, and I have run over, but I've put some wall boards up on the side there, that you can have a look at if you're interested.